गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड वेल एट होम। सो हेयर आई एम विथ माई लेक्चर नंबर 29 ऑफ कमर्शियल स्टडीज क्लास 9th। सो इन दिस वीडियो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू एंड अ वेरी फ्रेश चैप्टर फॉर यू ऑल, दैट इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 9, पब्लिक सेक्टर इंटरप्राइजेज। स्टूडेंट्स, ऑलरेडी आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर 1 to 8, एंड दोज हू हैवन सीन दोज वीडियोज येट काइंडली फर्स्ट सी दैट। So let's proceed to this chapter. The topic number 1 is meaning of public enterprise. First of all, let's understand the meaning of the chapter name. That is our public enterprises. Now, what is the meaning of public enterprise? That already I have explained in the previous chapter in very short. So let's study in detail. So the term public enterprise refers to such industrial and commercial enterprises which are owned and controlled by the central or the state government. So those enterprises which are owned and controlled, they are also owned as well as they are managed and controlled by the central or either the state government, they are known as the public enterprises. We have already discussed about the private enterprise, that which are owned by the private individuals, private businessmen, private people. They are known as the private enterprises, while those enterprises which are managed by the government, are known as public enterprises. Why they are known as public enterprises? Because the government is working for the welfare of the people. And because of this, they are named as public enterprises. Hope you are clear with the definition. It's very short and easy. So, means those industrial and the commercial enterprises which are owned by the central or either the state government. So, let's proceed to the next topic, that is features of public enterprises. Now, for every feature and the merits or demerits or characteristics, whatever we are going to discuss, learn for every topic 5 points, minimum 5 points you have to learn, because that topic has the possibility to come in the long type question answers, and the long type question answers carries 5 marks. So better to learn 5 points for each and every topic. So let's proceed. Point number 1 is state ownership. Now, for a public enterprise, it is owned, this already in the previous slide I have told you that it is owned and controlled and managed by the central or the state government, or it can be jointly also, jointly owned by two or more of them. So there's a state ownership, means the ownership, the ownership and the management and the control is held in the hands of the central. Just either it can be central also, it can be at state level also, or it can be owned jointly by two or more of them also. So hope you are clear with the first point. Now second point is your state control. Now first we have talked about your ownership point. Now second point is your control. Now who is having the control of public enterprises? We have talked that it is owned by the central government or either the state government, or jointly it can be owned by two or more of them. But it is, and now who is having the control? The ultimate control of public sector enterprises lies with the government, which can be central government also, state government also, and which appoints its board of directors and the chief of executive. So the government has a power, has a full control that whom to appoint as a board of directors and whom to appoint as a chief executive. So ultimate control lies in the hands of the government. Government, whosoever he thinks will appoint the person as a board of directors and chief executive. Board of directors is a group of directors who manages the company, just on behalf of the entire members of that company. So the full control lies in the hands of the government. Hope you are clear with this point. Now third point is your government financing. Now who finances, who provide the money for managing the company, for running the company? This, of course, because it is owned by the government, because it is owned by the government, it's controlled by the government, and hence the financing will also be done by the government. The whole or a major portion of the capital of public enterprise is provided by the government. Now, if the government also sometimes, you know, offer the public some shares, financing of the government company, public enterprises, is partly done by the government itself and partly by the public. And how the public finance the public enterprises? They purchase the shares of that company. And when they purchase the shares, the cost price of the shares give the finance to the public enterprises, and with that money they can run they can carry on their company. So the financing is done partly by the government also and partly by the public also. So both have the major role. Now fourth one is your service motive. Now we have talked about that for a private enterprise, their main motive is to earn money. We have already discussed many times. But for a public sector enterprises, their main role is to render service towards the society at large. Their main motive is not to earn the profits, but to, you know, fulfill the satisfaction of the people, fulfill the desires and the needs of the people at large. Then they will not think about the profit. They may even incur losses for their purpose, but their main motive, you know, primary motive, is to fulfill the satisfaction, the needs, the desires of the people which they are having. So their main motive is to serve the people, serve the society at a very large scale. And they may also even incur losses for that purpose. Now, fifth one is the public accountability. Now, accountability, the word accountability means responsible. Now, for a public enterprise, it is responsible, it is accountable to the public, to the common people. It is accountable to the common people. Now, what is the, you know, what is the significance of the accountable word here? That for a public enterprise, it must show all the accounts and all the records, all the activities to the common people, to the common people. While the private enterprise need not to do so. Private enterprise are not required to do so. But the public enterprise needs to present all its accounts, all its records, and this show all its activities also to the public. Why? Because the public has invested in the company. I have told you in the previous point that the public also financed the public sector enterprise partly. So if the public are investing in the company, public common people has the full right to know what is the position of that company, how much profit that company is incurring, how much losses that company is incurring. So common people have the full right because they're financing. So public enterprises are financed out of the public money, and therefore they are accountable for their results to the public. Public sector enterprise cannot hide any of the facts from the common public. They need to reveal all the details of the activities which they are doing, all the details of the profit, how much money they have invested in the various sectors. They need to represent all such things, and they cannot hide. While if we talk about private sector enterprise, they have the right to reveal only those facts which are important, and they can just hide the remaining of the fact because they are company is not financed from the common public. So hope all the 5 points are clear to you. Let's proceed to our last topic of this video, that is objectives and rationale of public enterprise. The meaning of rationale is importance. So if the question will come about the importance, so don't get confused, students. It's the objectives and the importance are same. The first importance and the first objective is rapid industrialization. वेरी द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइज इज़ टू यू नो रैपिड इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, मीन्स टू इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज इन द कंट्री. बिकॉज एज यू नो दैट आर कंट्री हैज़ अ पुअर इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, हैज़ अ पुअर इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड विच कैन बी ओनली इम्प्रूव्ड इफ वी इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज इन आर कंट्री. So for increasing the economic growth in a country, we need to have a substantial increase in the industrialization. We need to increase the industrial output. And this can be possible only with the establishment of public enterprises, more number of enterprises, and it would be profitable just if the industries are set up publicly, means they are set up just financed by the government also and financed by the public also. So rapid industrialization, the most important objective of the public enterprises is to set up the more number of public enterprises in the country so as to improve the economic growth of the country, because as you know that economic growth is very much poor of our country. Now the second point says balanced regional development. This point already I have explained in the previous videos also. So balanced regional development means to make all the areas equally developed, which is not so in our country, because in our country some areas are very much developed while some of the areas are very backward. So now the public enterprises, their main objective is to maintain the balanced regional development, means to make all the areas equally developed. So what how the public enterprises do so, they often set the new industries, they often set up the new industries in the backward areas to remove the regional differences. So now what the public enterprises are doing, they are setting the new industries in the backward areas so that they can have the balanced regional development, they can and develop all the areas equally, because those areas which are already developed, they need not to be developed further. Those areas needs to be overlooked which are backward, and they can and their backwardness can be removed when the new type of industries would be set up in those areas. So the important objective is to maintain the balanced regional development of all the areas equally. Hope you have got with this point. Now let's proceed to the point number third, employment. This is another objective of the public sector enterprises or the government, you can also say. Employment, creating more number of employment opportunities. Public enterprises provides opportunities for gainful employment to millions of people. These enterprises creates more and more jobs, thereby improving the per capita income of the people. So every government enterprise or the public enterprise creates more number of employment opportunities, and thereby they are improving the per capita income of the people also, and they are improving the living standard of the people also. Because if their per capita income will increase, that will automatically increase the living standard of people. Now your question must be how? Because if you are getting, suppose if you are getting 10 rupees as your monthly income, suppose. So you must be spending 6 rupees on various things. Now suppose if your income is doubled, so now you can spend more and you can have more variety of the goods. Now you can spend 16 rupees, 16 or 15 rupees. So now you can have more variety of the goods. So that increases our standard of living. So it creates more number of employment opportunities to millions of people. Now fourth one is optimum utilization of the resources. Now this is a very important point and a very crucial point, that if we talk about private sector enterprises, so obviously for producing the goods they will utilize the resources. But since the private sector, their main motive is to earn money, to earn profit, they will not strive hard to save the limited resources. They will not pay attention for saving such limited resources. They will only, you know, produce the goods and earn the profit. That's it. But public sector enterprises, they will produce the goods with the minimum utilization of resources. They will try to save our limited resources in the best possible manner which they can. So public enterprise helps to eliminate wasteful consumption, competition. They provide socially useful goods and essential commodities which are short in supply. So they try to produce those goods which are very essential and then short in supply. So they try to eliminate the wasteful consumption. So that is the optimum utilization of resources, which is the most important point. Now, fifth one is self-reliance. The meaning of self-reliance is to make the country independent. Self-reliance, the word self-reliance means independent. It's mentioned here, independent. Now, one of the main objective of the public enterprise is to make the country independent. Every government, every public enterprise wants that their country should be independent. Their country should not be dependent on other countries for their products. So every country's government try to make their country independent. And how they can do so? By increasing the exports. Now, what is exports? By exports means selling the goods to other countries. When we sell the goods to other countries, that is known as exports, selling. And imports means buying the goods from other countries. So don't get confused with these words. Keep these words in in your mind, because these are very important terms in your commerce. So exports means to sell and imports means to buy. So we can make our country independent if we increase our exports, if we increase the selling to other countries, and if we just decrease our imports, means we should not buy from the other countries. We should be sufficient enough to produce all the goods in our country itself, and we should try to minimize our imports. We should try to minimize the buying from other countries, and we should make our country self-dependent. We should try to make all the products in our country so that our country can become just independent. And we can do so by increasing our exports, means selling, and we can decrease our imports also, that is buying. So hope you are clear with all the points. I hope so. So this was the end of this video. The rest of the topics would be just discussed in my next video. So keep on revising, students. Till then, be safe at home and have a nice day, students.